Origin and Necessity of Religion by Dr. H.S. Sinha. There is a vast difference between dharma and religion. In English, there is no synonym for dharma. There are many dharmas in the world, but we will consider only the major ones for analysis. We will only consider the major dharmas prevalent in India like Sanatana Dharma, Islam, Christianity, Buddhism, Jainism, and Sikhism. When the British arrived in India, they found there was much discussion about dharmas. They wanted to know what is dharma. The local scholars tried to explain the meaning to them. Dharmo dharayate praja. Dharma is that which has the sustenance power. Dharma of fire is to burn. If that quality is removed, it cannot be called fire. Similarly, dharma of water is to cool, without which it loses its identity. Hence, dharma is that which sustains the basic or the fundamental essence of something. Dharma of a society is that which preserves the essence of the society and prevents its destruction. The British found the word religion as the most appropriate synonym, since religion is also a cohesive or a binding factor to preserve the essence of society. Since then, both dharma and religion are being used as synonyms, although they are not exactly the same. What is the importance of religion? Is it required for man, or is it a hypocrisy? Is it a cave of ignorance? Religion is required for an ignorant person. A person seeking knowledge and enlightenment comes out of this cave only to realize the bright light outside. He realizes that he has all along lived in ignorance. A person seeking enlightenment should come out of religion. That's why there have been efforts to end the concept of religion in the past. The first and foremost blow was from Charles Darwin. Till then, people believed that there was a creator of the universe. Darwin's theory negated this belief. Matter has created the universe, and hence matter or the creation cannot be destroyed too. When a person dies, he becomes part of the matter. Thus, matter can change its form but cannot be destroyed. The Darwinian theory destroyed the belief systems of the church. It was also later proved that there is inorganic matter and organic matter. That which had a well-organized matter was called organic matter. Inorganic matter was supposedly that which had no fixed or specific proportions of the components of matter. Darwin's theory states that consciousness evolved from the organic matter. It was a random event not created by someone. He stated that God is man's own creation to cover up for his ignorance. Then came Spencer, who focused on evolution of society and not matter. According to him, man was a free roaming nomad, just like an atom. Later, he developed associations with other men and started to live in an organized manner, which can be compared to organic matter. Spencer conceptualized man as a social organism who evolved from the simpler state to the more complex according to the universal law of evolution. For people who do not know about Spencer, he developed a theory of two types of society, the militant and the industrial, which corresponded to this evolutionary progression. Militant society, structured around relationships of hierarchy and obedience, was simple and undifferentiated. While industrial society, based on voluntary, contractually assumed social obligations, was complex and differentiated. Society, which Spencer conceptualized as a social organism, evolved from the simpler state to the more complex according to the universal law of evolution. The next person to destabilize religion was Karl Marx. He viewed religion in the social context and focused on the inequalities of society. He said that the society consists of people who have excess resources and those who have scarce resources. The power of people in the society depended on the preservation capacity of persons like food, money, goods, etc. People started families when their preservation capacity increased and they had more space. Society migrated from hunting profession to agriculture when man realized the limitations of the preservation methods of meat. He realized that food grains and other plant-based products had a longer shelf life. Soon, feudalism started with feudal lords exploiting the agriculture workers. Another class of people came into power gradually who discovered efficient ways of preserving food. They claimed to possess supernatural powers and ignorant people believed them. They were made to believe that such powers were beyond their capacity. This class of people gradually became the priests or the pastors who worked along with and in favor of the feudal lords. They attributed their supernatural powers to a force called God. Thus, they became agents or the shadows of God. The poor were told that the only entity that can keep them happy is God. They also started luring poor and ignorant people to part with their modest belongings for a reservation in paradise. The creation of God became an easy tool for exploitation of the poor. They were preached that poverty is a virtue and an eligibility criterion to enter the gates of heaven. It was also reiterated in the Bible that a rich man cannot enter heaven. Even a camel can pass through the eye of a needle, but a rich man cannot pass through the entrance of heaven. Blessed are those who are poor, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Any rebellion against these powerful people was considered as a rebellion against God. Even the causes of vagaries of nature, like excessive rainfall, famines, floods, were attributed to disobedience of the common people against the powerful people. This way, the gullible common people were exploited both by feudal lords and the self-proclaimed religious leaders. The masses were repeatedly told to believe in God and remain happy with whatever they could earn and not rebel. Karl Marx said that religion is like the opium of the masses. He opined that until people believed in religion, no industrial revolution would help in alleviating poverty. He wanted a revolution against religion. Karl Marx said sarcastically that the bells of church start ringing in the evening only to drown the voices of poor children of labor class crying for food when he reaches home. He told them to stop the church bells from ringing so that the cries of the children can be heard by God sitting in heaven. He urged the masses to revolt against church. He also tried to influence the masses by saying that if God is offered expensive dry fruits and cake in the church, why would he come to your poor hut for a measly meal? He spared no efforts to destabilize the church and the religion. Sigmund Freud was the next to shake the roots of religion. He came to be known as the pioneer in psychoanalysis. He looked at a human being as a bundle of sex with an orientation towards sensual pleasure in all his activities. He laid emphasis on the sexual identity of a person. According to Freud's psychoanalytic theory, the id is the primitive and the instinctual part of the mind that contains the sexual and aggressive drives and hidden memories, while the superego operates as a moral conscience. And the ego is the realistic part that mediates between the desires of the id and the superego. Sex is the act in which man is capable of getting maximum satisfaction with minimum effort. Due to societal norms, man's sexual urge had to be suppressed. Most religions also termed sex as a sinful act due to which there was always a conflict between the natural instincts and the societal expectations. Freud's theory normalized the sexual behaviors, which was against the preachings of the church. Freud attributed this to the conflict between id and the ego in a personality, the basic instincts always trying to overpower the ego. Religion tried to give the standards of morality.